Hello students, let's we continue our lesson that is energy flow in an ecosystem. The next topic that is biogeochemical cycle. Through the energy flow in an ecosystem is one way. The flow of nutrients is cyclical. Students, we have learned that the energy flow in an ecosystem that is one way because we are taking the energy from the sun, but it is not given back to the sun, and that's why that is called the energy flow in an ecosystem that is one way. The flow of nutrients that is cyclical, but the flow of nutrient that is cyclical, why it is said? Because the energy that and nutrients that is passes from one level to the another level till the decomposers, and again the nutrients that is decomposed by the decomposers and again given to the plants, and again that cycle is continued. That is why it is said that is nutrient flow is cyclical. All organisms need nutrients for their growth. Study the various components in the figure given alongside and explain the biogeochemical cycle in your own words. So here you have given the biogeochemical cycle, that is the different components you have given in this figure in your word, that is you have to be explained. So here you have given the conversion of lithosphere into rock soil, then the interactions of hydrosphere, atmosphere, lithosphere with the biosphere, then the hydrosphere, atmosphere, there is an interactions, how that is interactions occur there, then the atmosphere and environment, how the interactions is occur there, then the cyclical flow of nutrients within the ecosystem is called the biogeochemical cycle. Here we have given the definition of the biogeochemical cycle, that is the cyclical flow of nutrients within the ecosystem is called the biogeochemical cycle. Nutrients necessary for the growth of organisms are continuously transferred from abiotic to biotic factors and abiotic to abiotic factors within an ecosystem. This cycle operates continuously through the medium of the biosphere, from by the lithosphere, atmosphere and hydrosphere. So related to this figure, you have given the explanation how the cycle is continuous. That is the nutrient cycle, how that is continuous in this biosphere. The necessary nutrients, they are related to their growth. The organism are continuously transferred from abiotic to a biotic factor. So we get the vegetables, means they related to the plants from the environment, and that is the biotic thing. And from that is get to abiotic and biotic to abiotic. Like this, the cycle is continuous there within an ecosystem. This cycle operates continuously through the medium biosphere. So in the biosphere, that is that contain that atmosphere, lithosphere, hydrosphere, all this, and the atmosphere that is included in all the biosphere. The recycling of biological, geological and chemical sources of nutrients in this process is a complex process and depends upon the level of energy transfer in the ecosystem. Actually, this recycling of biological, geological and chemical sources of nutrients, this is complex process and depends upon the level of energy, how the level of energy is there. Less amount is there or higher amount is there, that is depend on that only, and that is transfer in the ecosystem. We have learned already that is how the energy is passes from one level to the higher level, but it is not given as it is to the another level, it reduces from lower to the higher level. Then next we have given the types of biogeochemical cycle. There is in two types of biogeochemical cycle. First, gaseous cycle, and second, that is sedimentary cycle. Gaseous cycle. An accumulation of the main abiotic gaseous nutrients material is found in the Earth's atmosphere. Second, includes nitrogen, oxygen, carbon dioxide, water vapor, etc. In gaseous cycle, there is an accumulation of main abiotic gaseous. You have given the example of that. The nutrient material is found in the Earth atmosphere, that is oxygen, nitrogen, carbon dioxide and water vapor. Then sedimentary cycle, in an accumulation of the main abiotic nutrients materials is found in soil, sediments and sedimentary rocks, etc. of the earth, that includes soil components like iron, calcium, phosphorus, etc. The gaseous cycle is a speeder cycle than the sedimentary cycle. For example, if carbon dioxide has accumulated in an area, it is quickly disappear with the wind or absorbed by the plants. Climate change and human activity seriously affect the speed, intensity and equilibrium of these cycles. Hence, various aspects of these cycles are extensively studied nowadays. Students, gaseous cycle is a rapidly that is occur, but sedimentary cycle that is occur very slow in compared to the gaseous cycle. We have given the example of here of the carbon dioxide. If that is accumulated in the area, that is quickly dispersed or that is absorbed by the plants. Why the plants they are absorbed? Because for their production of the food, and they given out the oxygen in the surrounding or in the atmosphere. Next, do you know the cycle of gases and the sedimentary cycle cannot be completely separated from each other? For example, nitrogen is present in the form of gas in the atmosphere and in the form of compounds like nitrogen oxide in the soil and sediments. Similarly, carbon occurs in abiotic form mainly in coal, granite, diamond, limestone, etc. in the earth's crust, and in the form of carbon dioxide gas in the atmosphere. Generally, carbon is present in plants and animals for a much shorter duration than it is in coal. Students, we have given here information about the gaseous cycle and the sedimentary cycle. They are not completely separated from each other. They are depend from each other. So here we have see that is the example of nitrogen, oxygen, carbon dioxide, water vapor. They are included in gaseous cycle. And other that we have given the like iron, calcium, phosphorus, they are also included in sedimentary cycle. But here they have given the example that is nitrogen is present in the form of gas in the atmosphere, that is in the gaseous cycle. But the compound like nitrogen oxide that is present in the soil means it comes under the sedimentary cycle. Similarly, carbon occurs in abiotic form mainly the coal, granite and diamond, limestone, etc. So here we have given the carbon, that carbon dioxide is included in the gaseous cycle, but when we are talking about only the carbon, that is actually mainly occurs from coal, granite and diamond, limestone, and that included in sedimentary cycle. In earth crust, the form carbon dioxide gas in the atmosphere, afterwards that is then process, chemical processes occur there, and then it is formed the carbon dioxide, and that present in the atmosphere. Generally, carbon is present in the plants and animals for much shorter duration than it is in the coal.